Miranda, are you going to smile? Are you going to smile for Mama?
The first 5 years of life is one of the most remarkable time spans in the whole life cycle.
Are you a happy baby?
The transformation from the uncoordinated bundle of wants and needs that is the newborn infant to the running, talking, socially aware, and boundlessly curious 5-year-old is truly a wonder to behold. Hello, I'm David Elkind, and in this film we're going to explore the intellectual development that takes place during the first 5 years of life. Jean Piaget viewed the environment as relatively passive. To him, it provided the nourishment for mental growth. It was the child who actively constructed reality out of his or her experience with the environment. In contrast, Vygotsky argued that the environment, particularly the human interactions of parents and teachers, plays an active and necessary role in the child's construction of social and physical reality. More simply, for Piaget, development is from the egocentric to the sociocentric, whereas for Vygotsky, just the reverse holds true. I'm going to elaborate on 3 areas of cognitive development during the first 5 years of life: the development of reasoning, perception, and language. As with all human intellectual activity, these areas are interconnected and interdependent. They are also intimately associated with and dependent upon emotional and social development. Let's start with reasoning, an area in which the work of Jean Piaget is preeminent. Young children, to illustrate, define words in terms of actions or properties. What is a dog?
Something that lives in the house and barks at night.
Oh, lives in the house and barks at night in the morning, okay.
Older children define these terms by placing them in larger categories.
And what is a dog?
A dog is an animal. It barks.
Uh-huh.
It has 4 legs.
It has 4 legs.
Now let us turn to our second subject, visual perception. Young children who lack perceptual regulations are not able to decenter, and they perceive only the more dominant of the ambiguous figures.
A butterfly.
A butterfly. Here's another picture. What do you see in this picture?
A tree and branches on it.
Tree and branches on it. Okay. Anything else?
No.
Older children are able to see both figures.
What do you see?
I see a cat.
A cat, uh-huh.
And a tree trunk. Okay.
This brings us to the third area of cognitive development we are examining, namely, language acquisition. Vygotsky saw language development as a co-construction between a child and her caregivers. The essential nature of adult intervention in Vygotsky's theory has important implications for the active nurture of young children. More than Piaget, however, he stressed the importance of the early language experiences of babies. Vygotsky developed a stage theory of the interaction of thought and language. Through these crucial interchanges, babies start imitating words. We hope that this film and other films in the series will contribute to a deeper understanding of and appreciation for the extraordinary intellectual attainments of young children.